Live on your health tonight, a controversial new study about autism. The results suggest a natural element found in some tap water may raise the risk. Here to explain is Dr. Scott Hadland, Chief of Adolescent and Young Adult Medicine at Mass General for Children. Dr. Hadland, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Dr. Hadland, as you know, researchers still have not determined why some kids develop autism spectrum disorder. Could be genetics, could be environmental factors. What can you tell us about this potential connection, though, to lithium levels in drinking water?
Right. Well, you know, about 1 in 36 children in the United States are diagnosed with an autism spectrum disorder. And so, you know, there are a lot of questions about, you know, why this happens. Is it genetics? Is it an environmental factor? And, you know, we as pediatricians care for a lot of kids with autism. Many of us in, you know, your viewership will know family members who have it. And so this study is really, I think, one that people are paying a lot of attention to. They basically studied lithium, which is a metal that's found in the earth and can in some situations get into drinking water. Now I'll say we don't have a lot of that here in Massachusetts. And the authors studied the exposure of pregnant women to drinking water that had lithium levels in it in Denmark, and found that there was a link between the amount of lithium that women drank and the risk of autism in their offspring.
So talking a little bit more about this apparent connection, this apparent link, do you think the study shows kind of a clear causation between lithium and autism?
I think that this is a first study out of the gate that causes us to ask a lot of questions and makes us want to do more research on this topic. You know, we often say that correlation is not causation, meaning that we see a link between things, but that doesn't necessarily mean that lithium causes autism. So I would anticipate that we'll want to do a lot of studies. I will say that this study was done well. It was big. It had more than 8,000 children with autism in Denmark that were studied. And there really was this association whereby when they looked back at mothers and how much lithium they may have been exposed to in drinking water in Denmark, the higher the levels of lithium that they were exposed to, the more likely this risk. And so there is sort of this association there that really does make us wonder and want to do further studies on this.
All right, some parents might hear about this study and think, you know, just to be safe, let's get rid of all the lithium batteries. What do you want those folks to know?
Yeah, it's important to remember this is lithium in drinking water. So this is very different from lithium in batteries, for example, that might be in your cell phone or in other electronics around the house. And lithium is in other things too. It's, you know, it's in air conditioners, it's in certain types of oils, but typically not ingested. You know, you're not usually exposed to it by eating or drinking something. And here in Massachusetts, when lithium levels have been checked, typically they are basically non-existent. And so I'm not very worried about this being an exposure that people here in Massachusetts will want to worry about. But it is something that raises eyebrows and makes us want to study this more. But again, I would caution folks, this is really just one study. The links between autism and the various things that cause it are pretty complex. And I suspect that this is just one piece of a very big puzzle that we'll follow up on with further research.
All right, Dr. Scott Hadland at Mass General for Children. Dr. Hadland, good to see you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.